yeah. I just called to say I love you, and I mean it from the bottom of my heart. No summer's high, no warm July, no harvest moon to light one tender August night. No autumn breeze, no falling leaves, not even time for birds to fly to southern skies. No Libra sun.
We're playing a little Stevie Wonder this morning. I just called to say that I love you.
No giving thanks to all the Christmas joy you bring. But what it is, the old summer. Just fill your heart like no three words could ever do. I just want to say I love you. I just want to say how much I care about you. I just want.
This is Real Talk with Trinese. This is a radio show. So those of you who are listening, letting people know that this is a radio station. And we are authorized to play all this music on this station. So whoever is trying to block these videos, live videos, this is a radio station that plays all kind of artist music.
I love you, and I mean it from the bottom of my heart. Oh, my heart. Oh, my heart.
Good morning. Real Talk with Trinese is on the air live. We have a special guest coming at the second hour. Reuben DeTiege will be here. Those of you who are watching live, shout out to you. I'm inviting you again because the first video with Aretha Franklin's music was blocked. And this is a radio station, so we are authorized to play music. We don't own the rights, but we can play music on this radio station. So just letting people know, I don't know who's continuously trying to block the music, the Aretha Franklin music that I was playing and all that, but that video was blocked from other countries. So. And I constantly have to fight with YouTube and all that. Every time I put up a live video or a video of the radio show, they try to block it and then I dispute it. So people need to understand that this is a radio station. Crescent City Radio, www.crescentcityradio.com. All right. So after this song, we'll finish talking, discussing the beautiful Aretha Franklin. All right, guys, good morning. I am back. Those of you who are just joining me, I had to start this video over. This is a radio station, CrescentCityRadio.com. This is Real Talk with Trinese. I'm here every Friday at 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. Central Standard Time. We talk about everything from whatever politics, religion, or whatever it is that we want to discuss. It's Real Talk. We lay it on the table. We even have a phone number where you can call. If you want to call and share your thoughts about Aretha Franklin and tell us your favorite song or whatever it is, favorite memory or whatever, you can call 504-865-3635, 504-865-3635, and I will put it in the comments on the Facebook page so people can call in and share your thoughts, or you just want to come in and call in and say hello. Because again, we are celebrating the life of Aretha Franklin because she left a mark that is beyond replaceable. Beyond replaceable. Beyond replaceable is what I want to say. What I want to say, guys, I was saying that we need to know that we not only need to possess great gifts or whatever your gifts are, we don't need to master just our gifts. We need to master our character. See, when you have great character with the gifts, which are God-given talents and God-given gifts, great character, it goes a long way. Character will take you further than your talent. And I believe Aretha Franklin's spirit was so beautiful, spirit in all the lives that she touched and all the artists that she worked with have beautiful stories. Not to say that she's had her tribe. She's, you know, nobody's perfect. Nobody's 100% perfect. And I'm pretty sure they have people, they have negative moments with Aretha Franklin, but I'm sure it didn't stay there. So what I want to say, guys, when you master your character and you have great character alongside with your gifts, you can take over the world. She is known all over the world. Outstanding, beautiful voice that just not can't be echoed or copied. And when God stamp an original print on you, it's just amazing. I'm so glad that I was in her lifetime, that I was able to listen to her music as my parents played that music, and I was able to hear it. It was just extraordinary. I'm very, very, very proud of all the work that she has done, all the things that she's done, community work that she's done, which is beyond the scene, beyond the stage, beyond you know, the fashion or whatever it is, beyond writing, beyond producing. Her character took her further, her greatness. And, you know, I was listening to some of the testimonies of Jesse Jackson and some of the stories of other people were saying that she would invite you to her home and you would feel at home. She loved to cook and she would make you feel warm and at home. That is a character trait that will carry you. And a lot of us need to look in the mirror to see, hey, do I have a great character? Am I a great artist alongside with a great character? That makes a lot of sense. That pushes you further. Am I just doing my talents, or am I mastering my talents, or am I mastering my character? Do I have integrity? You know, am I holding an ego that doesn't inspire people? That how do people feel when they are actually around me? When do they feel inspired? You have to make a mark on others. We are here for others. That's what people need to understand. We are here for others and to inspire others and inspire people to do better. When we do better as an individual, others can follow. So how do you make people feel as your character also with your gifts? How do people feel when they leave your presence? How do people, what do they say about you? What are people going to say about you when you're gone? She's gone, but she's here. and people are affected by it. I shed my tears. A lot of people shedding tears, still shed her family, her close family, her children, her grandchildren, all of that. She was an icon, a matriarch in her family, and she was a matriarch in many people's families, meaning that she influenced so many parents, grandparents, great grandparents. You know, my family, you know, we heard Aretha Franklin in the houses. We grew up on great music with substance and meanings. Even the things that she went through as a wife and as a young mother, and although you can feel that in her music, when you can poetically put things in music and for people to hear and to people understand and to people be inspired, that is an extraordinary gift. So I want everybody to challenge themselves as an artist or a business person or whatever you are. Are you mastering your character besides just your gifts? Because Aretha Franklin did that and more. And I can't say that enough, that we are losing our great icons. We are losing our great legends, yearly and daily. We are using even the ones that we haven't even heard about on the mainstream, the ones that are doing great things in their communities, in their cities, that we don't get to see on the news. Those communities are losing people. We are losing people. And unfortunately, we are losing people younger and younger these days. You know, a lot of people are not making it to 90 and 95 years old or 100 years old. A lot of people are not making it that far because it's just the injustices and the things in the atmosphere, the evilness and the food. They're putting things in our food. You just don't know. You got to take care of yourself because a lot of us are leaving before our time. So we got to cherish and preserve our people that are doing great things. And you challenge yourself to do better every day. A lot of us are mothers and fathers, and our children look up to us, and we want other children to look up to us. We want communities to look up to us. You know, even if your name might not be in lights, or you might not get a street name after you like she did, and won, I believe she won, if I'm not mistaken, 18 Grammys or maybe more. I mean, that says a lot about her. And I'm telling you guys, it works if you are a great person, great character, and you love people and you have compassion. It's going to take you further than your talent. Some people are wondering why they're stagnated. Why? I mean, I'm good at what I do, but are you great at your personality? Are you great at your character? Can you inspire your people? Can you be humble in your great gifts? Because what happens, people are so great. Some people get so great in their craft and their gifts, but they have an ego. Nobody can touch me. I'm all this and I'm all that. And I put people beneath me. And so many people wondering why their careers or their businesses are not flourishing and things are not happening, because you need to check your flesh and you need to check your character, because it goes a long way. It goes a long, long way. And when I say that because I'm a witness of it. I realize, and when I get out of character with somebody, or I get angry with somebody, or and I say something, I make sure I apologize. I make sure I'm sorry, and I don't treat people with disrespect, okay? Even some of us may know that we are better gifted in some areas than other people. We are better writers, or maybe we're better playwrights, or whatever you are. You may be better than some people in that craft, but that doesn't make you a better person. Okay, let's understand that. Doesn't make you a better person, because let me say this: you may be better crafted in your gift than the next person, but the person may have a better character than you. Do you understand what I just said? So the person that you may have more plaques on the wall, you may have more diplomas on the wall, you may have more degrees or whatever than that person in their craft, but their character is much better than yours. They're more humble. So you got to check yourself, people. Let's check ourselves and make sure that we're doing great things beyond our talents and gifts. And I see my great guest of Reuben DeTiege just walked in, and we're going to put a music break on so we can get him settled in and get this awesome interview on the air. Guys, stay with us. I'm so happy to be talking about this woman and so many other great artists that she inspired, the Gladys Knights, the Patti LaBelle, all those people that's in her era, Diana Ross, all those people that's in her era, you better believe they were inspired by her. Even Tina Turner, you better believe, because everybody have a different craft, everybody have a different gift, everybody have a different way that they do things. But you better believe everybody can relate to Aretha Franklin. She did the gospel, she did the rock and roll, she did soul music, R&B, it doesn't matter. She even touched on a little opera classical. So guess what, guys? When God give you those gifts that you can master it with love. Show people, hey, I'm good, great at this, but I'm also a great person. And that's what matters. That's what matters, and people don't understand that. People don't get it. I so get it. I got that a long time ago. Even when I didn't know my full potential, I didn't know the things that God has gifted me with. Even I found out that I had gifts later on in my adult years. I did not possess an ego. I didn't walk around with an ego. I still stayed humble in my place, and I don't have a problem. If you don't have a problem uplifting and elevating others, even though you know you're great, but you can tell another person that's great, oh, you're fantastic, congratulations, and mean it, and celebrate others, support people, genuinely support people, whether it's whatever it is, some kind of gesture, it goes a long way. I was talking to a man that was about 90 years old, now I'm not going to say 90, maybe 85, and he wanted to get a lawnmower at my job. That, you know, he was asking about a lawnmower. Can a manager mark it down? And I say, I'm pretty sure they will. And the thing is, he said, you know, maybe if I can give them some donuts, that might work. Maybe if I give them some donuts, that might work. But he this is what he said, and it made a lot of sense. And I've said it before. He said, every time he goes to the doctor to get his checkup, he brings a dozen of glazed donuts. And he said, them people be looking for those donuts. They appreciate those. And a small gesture, as the donuts probably was $3.50 a dozen or $4, wherever he bought them from. But people will appreciate the small gestures that you do. So when he goes to the doctor, people light up, and then he's always bringing something. So that those little nuggets, those little things that you can do in somebody's life, or even giving a garbage man a bottle of water. When you see him sweating and he's on the back of that truck picking up your garbage, you give him a bottle of water, that goes a long way. Even if you see somebody at work and your child has outgrown their clothes and you see that child may need those clothes, you bring nicely folded clothes in a nice bag and give it to that mother and say, hey, listen, my child grew out of these clothes. And I see that your child can fit these clothes. Hey, I want to bless you with that. You know what I'm saying? Blessing goes a long way. Small gestures goes a long way. And that's what I'm talking about, that character going beyond your gifts and your talents. Just those little things that you do for others, it goes a long way, guys. So I'm going to put another song on, and we're going to go ahead and get our guests settled in so we can start our amazing interview with Mr. Reuben DeTiege. I am very excited that he's here. He's a good friend of mine. I'm glad that he's here. And we're going to talk about all the things that he's doing, all the events that he's doing, and the importance of having great character. All right.
It was more of a part of my life than I knew. You know what I'm saying? Because I mean, everything they play. Yeah. And I'm sitting there thinking, where I was at that time.
That's what that music does to you, like that.
Well,
yeah, I feel money.
But they need a program.
Well, the most of the programs is like
90s. Oh, gotcha.
See, we got a lot of programs.
Oh, gotcha.
I think
oh, gotcha.
Yeah. So, what you got?
Yeah, that's my fly.
Okay.
Yeah. You know what? And I thought about some other groups going over some stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, that's not good. The concert can be your problem. I'm doing a gospel concert. You know, I don't have a fly for it. 28 My dude's supposed to be coming out with my stuff. There's two different people doing these two different things. But you have to have performance. So what you want to do?
I'm supposed to be doing spoken word.
You're saying my crowd is for
you? No, it's for me. You selling tickets for your next?
Yes. Yeah. Hey, everybody. We'll be, as soon as the song go off, we'll get right on it. All right.
Which one is your Facebook?
I got both of them Facebook. This is my I got two pages. That's one of my other pages. And this is, you know, both of them. So you can put yours on live if you want.
Somebody was saying that she could call. Can I get on that Wi-Fi too?
Yeah.
You
should be already in there. You did?
I didn't know that. Ray says hello. Hey, Ray.
Oh, you know Ray?
Yeah. Ray Perry?
Oh, yeah. She on the radio show next week. Yeah. You got it up?
Yeah, I'm gonna put it up now.
Okay.
The bottom definitely says hello.
Okay. Hello. So the internet is on.
Yeah. Okay.
So what you could do, you could put your live. Okay.
Yeah, she did a song with you.
She did?
Yeah, she did.
Wow. Wow.
I knew you were waiting.
Oh, yes. I do remember that. Oh, man, she did so much. So much.
I don't
remember either. Okay, you ready?
You good?
Okay.
All right, good morning, good morning. We are back with Real Talk with Trinese. I hope you enjoyed that music break. And we are excited to have my friend, my brother, Reuben DeTiege in the house.
I'm excited to be here.
Too. Excited to be here, guys. Yes, he is in the house. I am honored to have him in the studio because this man, like I said, has a long resume and is doing amazing things for other people. Like I was talking earlier about Aretha Franklin. We were just talking about on break, about how you've been crying.
Well, let me tell you.
And how, tell us, what has her death, how has it affected you? But when she was living, how did it affect you?
That lady, obviously, and I didn't realize. I think someone said good morning to all of you.
Good morning. Good morning.
Listeners. Good morning.
Good morning.
This is Reuben DeTiege for WSBN. I got to tell you, you know, I picked up my son yesterday from St. Aug, and he was like, why are you looking like that? I said, man, we lost a great woman. And like a couple of months back, this rapper who I don't know, they call him X.
Okay.
And something happened to him. He died. He felt bad. He was like, oh, man. So I'm just going to my room and sit down for a while.
Okay.
This lady was like the fabric of my life.
Okay.
And I didn't realize how much I heard she was going to be at Jazz Fest this year. I went and bought the ticket the same day.
Oh.
I said, I got to say goodbye because I don't know
when
I'm going to see this lady again.
So Aretha Franklin was supposed to come.
She was supposed to play.
I heard that. I did hear that.
She was supposed to play Jazz Fest, and she was going to be there.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I'm in my 50s. I got to.
Yes.
I have to see her and Anita Baker.
Anita
Baker was saying, I'm saying goodbye.
And I'm going to do it.
But, you know, each song
was
a story in this woman's life.
Exactly. I just was saying that before you came.
You know,
just saying that. Yes.
I just saw her yesterday in a video with her and Smokey Robinson. And they were saying.
I shared it. And that's the video that made me cry.
Oh my God.
That's when I started crying.
I don't know if these young people understand.
They don't understand. I just.
You got to listen to the lyrics if you don't even hear the music.
Exactly. Exactly.
The these people saying.
Exactly.
Oh, baby, baby. That whole lyrics, you got to hear that.
Yes. 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 They don't get it. They don't get it.
And these people lived in a 6-block area. Listen to what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Four times.
Speak it.
Martha and the Vandellas. Diana Ross, one block over.
Yeah, man.
What kind of powerful block
was that?
Neighborhood.
Was that?
Smokey and then Robinson.
And coming up as a kid, coming up as a child in that neighborhood, hearing, you know, you probably heard them outside in the studio, the kids playing in the street, and they hear the music every night. You know, that was a phenomenal time and all of the hardship and oppression that black folks went through in that time. But music was their refuge. Music was their sanctity. Music was something that heals them. So just imagine going through the things you went through, but you hear Aretha Franklin in the studio, hear Diana Ross in the studio, hear Marvin Gaye in the studio. These young folks don't understand. They don't get it. They don't get it. They don't get it.
She did a song called Call Me.
Call Me.
She was telling the person to call them when they get away from her. I didn't understand.
Mm-hmm.
That song's about Vietnam. And her boyfriend left to go to Vietnam. And
What's the name of the song?
It's called Call Me.
Wow.
I don't know if you can pull it up somewhere.
Wow.
It's called Call Me.
So what the song was about?
The song was about two people in love, and she was leaving. One of the people was leaving. And she was saying, call me as soon as you get where you're going.
Yes.
And she was saying that they had never been apart before, and that was it. But her boyfriend had gone to Vietnam. Oh, my God. This lady was a storyteller. Unprovoked.
Man, that's what I'm saying.
It just.
Ooh.
I don't, you know, it just, I'm without words to say.
There's just no words you can describe
her. She wrote a song called Angel. I don't know.
I played it earlier.
Do you know what that song was about?
No, what it was about?
She was married to her manager. His name was Ken Cunningham.
Really?
And Ken Cunningham called on the phone one day and said, you need to talk to your sister. And her sister and him moved away and got married.
Ooh, what?
This lady had a ton of stuff going on.
Wait a minute.
Her sister was
song,
up in her backup singing her whole life.
The song Gotta Find Me an Angel.
You got right. Fly away with me.
Because she was so heartbroken by her husband and her sister. Oh, Lord.
And if you that
come on, bro. I just played the song.
You know who wrote Respect? Did you ever hear that song?
No.
Otis Redding wrote that before he,
and he wrote it for her.
Right. And then she added some stuff to it. Here's the part she said in Respect. She said, sock it to me, sock it to me. She said, in Detroit, that was a word people would say to each other.
Yes. You know,
like a hello kind of thing.
Yes, yes.
The television show Laughing took that and made millions of it.
Wait, what?
They used to say, sock it to me, baby.
Sock it to me, baby. And so a television show took
it. She said that was something that she took from the neighborhood and she put it in the song. Otis Redding didn't write that. She put it in there. And that's what that was about.
And somebody took it and ran with it.
Right. Marcus Miller produced the album for her and they just played it. I think she won about 4 Grammys. I may be wrong, ladies and gentlemen, but something like that.
Okay.
And she wrote the Grammys for the thing. She produced that album with Marcus Miller and Luther Vandross. They were talking about going on tour. They had so many back and forth, but respectful back and forth. They said, we're not going on tour, we're going to fight each other.
Because
he's a perfectionist and she is.
They say she was a perfectionist. They say she was stubborn, they say. Yeah. That's what Jesse Jackson said yesterday, that she was stubborn and you can't hardly get her to change her mind.
She said, he really said yesterday that he invited her some years ago. She invited him some years ago to her house for a private event.
Yes.
And she was there.
Mm-hmm.
And she said they was playing so many of her songs on the thing. She said she went and took the and stop the tape or whatever it was.
Uh-huh.
And someplace she said, you gotta tell jokes, not tell jokes.
Oh, what?
He said she was dragging on a cigarette and she just started, she said, tell a joke.
She was a smoker? I didn't know she was a smoker. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Wow.
That's just amazing. Hi, everybody out there.
Hi, everybody.
I'm sorry I'm going through this morning. I don't know. she's up there talking to my mom, probably talking out of death.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, my God. Yeah. We only got a few people left.
That's what I just said.
Y'all got bubble wrap them. Stephen Wonder, Gladys Knight.
You say you better what you said?
You better bubble wrap them because then we ain't got me down to a few. We took them all. Lord. We lost the king of soul, not a queen of soul. And I understand she had pancreatic cancer.
Yes, that's what they say.
That takes out everybody. I mean, that's probably the roughest one of the
of all of them, the right. Pancreatic. And I was listening to Jesse Jackson on his interview yesterday, and he said that she really was diagnosed in 2005.
Wow!
So she's been dealing with that over 15 years.
Right.
And he said that what inspired me what he said yesterday is that she fought to the end, meaning that she was, even though she was battling her sickness. She was fighting. She did Elton John with the AIDS benefit.
She did. She went there and they thought she wasn't going to perform.
She did what she did her best. And they said she fought to the end. And I just think.
Thank y'all for watching.
I just think it's nobody can duplicate that.
It'll never be duplicated.
Her.
I think I'm going to do on my radio station. We're going to do all day, maybe Sunday.
And
I don't want to bring y'all down too much. I mean, I'm just.
But we celebrating her. We're talking about her, and also, you know, I was talking about the character beyond the stage. You heard when I was talking about it,
right?
And a lot of, unfortunately, some of these artists that's coming up. They don't have that. They don't have what Aretha Franklin possessed as a woman, a character, like a substance, that meat, that, you know how we got the substance as a pot of gumbo with everything in it,
right.
Every ingredient in it. Some of these artists don't possess all those ingredients.
Well,
she had ingredients beyond ingredients.
They said some year in 1996, Pavarotti was supposed to perform on the Grammys.
Who?
Pavarotti, Luciano.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
And they said that, well, we need a substitute, so they called her. So she.
I saw it.
Which one of your songs you want? She sang. She said, I'm going to sing whatever y'all practice.
I love it.
And she sang his song. Pavarotti,
yes.
Song.
On a Grammys.
Perfection. So yeah. She said after she had such a good response for that, she put that in all her shows. That's amazing.
And you remember the little boy that, who was that, her grandson came ran on the stage and hugged her?
I don't remember seeing it, bro.
Yeah, I saw the clip yesterday. But again, guys, we just showing a lot of love to Aretha Franklin. I mean, we can talk about her all day and what she has brought to our lives, and just when you lose a great artist like that, you can't help but feel it.
You know, let me tell you, I was sad Michael Jackson died. I was even sadder when Prince died.
Oh, yes.
And I'm not saying I'm equating the two. They had two different things they were doing.
But yes.
This has hit me.
Like, it's hit you.
It is. I don't know. And I'm going to tell you what else hit me like that. Somebody had a joke on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
When Luther died, somebody said, well, when was it that you discovered that Luther was singing to a man?
Oh, yeah, I saw that post.
I still don't know that.
Yeah, I tell you, huh?
I still don't know that. You can see, well, room you in denial, but I still don't know that. I listen to the songs and I never get that in my mind. I don't have to keep it to yourself.
That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. Man. But we just celebrating her and we're talking about her. And you guys, I'm pretty sure you have some stories.
Thank you for having me on your show.
Man, look, you my friend, man. Look, we go way back. We've done some things, and
we're gonna do some more things.
So you know,
I'm at the lovely Loyola campus. I graduated from over here.
Isn't that something?
Yeah,
we at Loyola. Isn't it beautiful over here? Very peaceful.
Got a woman president now. Go Loyola.
Yeah. Yes, indeed.
Strides for.
Yes. So let's get into Mr. Reuben DeTiege.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell, you know, people that's on my live, he may not know.
Oh, Reuben. That's true. Okay, I need to introduce myself.
Yeah, people that may not know you, but tell them what you do. What do you know what your God gift calling is and what you have been doing with that calling? What you have been doing? Tell people who you are. Those of you,
that
my guests, that
me.
Don't know who you are.
I want to say hi to Bob and Ray, too.
Okay, hi, Bob and Ray. Yeah.
I am Reuben DeTiege. I am the owner and general manager of WSBN Radio. Mm-hmm. My real passion for all of this was, long ago, my grandfather was an entrepreneur. He was a barber back in your time. People may know that. And a civil rights activist.
Okay.
My grandfather is the reason that African Americans, minorities, everybody can go in the city park now.
Lawsuit
back in 1956, 55.
Now, you see, I didn't even know that.
And
what was your grandfather's name?
His name was Mandeville L. DeTiege.
Wow.
And he fought for civil rights. He used to play golf.
Okay.
From St. Martin Parish in St. Martinville, Louisiana.
Okay.
And he was a barber, so all his clientele were African Americans.
Wow.
He went to play golf, and they ran him off, said, you know, colored people can't play golf.
Okay.
Well, he got with A.L. Davis, I'll tell you the short version.
Okay.
A.L. Davis, I'm sorry.
Okay.
A.P. Tool.
Okay.
And he sued after being arrested because they had to have an action to move forward with a lawsuit.
Okay.
He got arrested. I was just sitting in the park. He had his army uniform on. My grandmother made him a lunch.
Okay.
And it took 11 years and some months to overturn it. And now African Americans can enjoy City Park like all other citizens.
Because of your grandfather.
Because of my grandfather.
Let me say this. Because of your grandfather.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm proud to say that too.
I've been going to City Park for years.
Y'all, excuse me.
City Park is one of my favorite spots to go to. I do a lot of my photography work in from City Park. So your granddaddy is the reason why I get to enjoy City Park.
Yeah, absolutely. Mandeville. Lawrence
DeTiege. Mandeville Lawrence DeTiege. God bless your soul. God bless your soul. And the importance of having people in your family do great things.
Right.
And it passed along down to you, Reuben, because you are so passionate, especially about our black people
having
every opportunity that our white counterparts have.
Well, because I see everybody else out there.
Yes.
And I'm gonna challenge your audience and I'm gonna challenge your viewers. And I'm
go ahead.
You know, when you go out to dinner, and let's say we go to Applebee's mm-hmm. or Fridays or somewhere like that, you may mm-hmm. take your family out back.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm asking, I know you see a lot of people in there, but do you see Asians in there? Do you see Hispanics? I don't usually see them in there. Well, there's a reason. Mm-hmm. Those people patronize their own.
Say that again. Say that, and that is so true. That's deep thinking, guys. Listen to what he just said. If you missed it, I want you to say that again. Those of you just joining us,
we go out to eat all the time. I take my family out to eat all the time. They enjoy going out acting. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's part of our.
Yeah, we love it too. Yeah, we go out there a lot. Yeah.
Enjoy that, and you come back. So I had a great day at a pasta thing.
Yes,
but,
yes.
But I gotta tell you, I do not see Asian families eating at those.
Asian families, you don't see them eating.
Well, because
you don't see Arabs eating either.
Right. Well, let me say this to you again.
Go ahead.
There are many people that left. Got displaced in Katrina, and they come back and say, when I come back then, I'm going to Chinese kitchen. And no disrespect a lot.
I understand.
I don't eat Chinese food, my personally myself.
Okay.
Other people do.
Okay.
But I do when they're going there, and I don't see other Asian people eating the food.
I get excited, y'all. Y'all know how I am.
I don't.
Y'all know how I am. I get excited when people say stuff that that I've been saying.
And
I have said it.
If you know that, please either respond on there or call me on the phone. 504-940-8964.
Oh, you can call 504-865-3635.
I see Asian people all the time. Tell me. I mean, challenge me. I want to be challenged.
Because guess what? Guess what? I've been saying that for years. And, and let me tell you something. I have a weakness for Chinese kitchen, but I don't go often.
Right.
I love the egg rolls. I grew up in Carrollton. So my parents, what we do, that'll be a treat for us to go to Chinese kitchen. And what we would do on weekends, we didn't really cook. We went out or ate or had food. So then we get Popeye's chicken. Let me tell you what the kind of combination we used to have.
Right.
And we used to have the Popeye's chicken, and we used to go to the rice, the shrimp fried rice with the Popeye's chicken. That's what we used to do.
Denise is serious.
So when you grew up on something and you the egg rolls, my God. And my God bless the day, my dad used to get the Mandarin chicken with the brown sauce. And I said, ooh, he liked that on nasty stuff. But sweet and sour chicken was my favorite. But again, when you go into Chinese kitchen, you see them eating what? Soup, white rice, vegetables, and tea. They are not eating the fried shrimp fried rice. They're not eating the boneless chicken. They're not eating anything.
I got a funny story.
That they serve us. And it's the truth, guys. Why is that? Even when you go to Cajun. I'm not blasting Cajun.
I ain't blasting me. I got a story about that too. Let me tell you.
Go ahead. Go ahead, Reuben.
Came back from the storm.
Mm-hmm.
My family enjoys Cajun. They get stuff out there, seafood and all that. Mm-hmm. Some lady at the counter, and I'm sitting there being.
Where you at again? Where are you?
At Cajun.
You at Cajun, okay.
And I'm sitting there, and that's why I'm going to get deep about this stuff. So the girl was there, whatever, and I said, excuse me, let me ask you a question. She said, well, I say, y'all serve Korean food now? Oh, no, I didn't. I'm going to go. I said, are you Korean? She said, yeah. She said, how do you know? I took a wild guess. I really didn't know. I said, y'all serve Korean food? She said, no, why?
At Cajun.
Wait, this is a Korean-owned restaurant. But y'all sell food for black people.
Exactly. No, why?
And I got to ask the question.
Mm-hmm.
So if Trinise and Oratree opened up a restaurant next door to them, would y'all move over and come over and I know they know how to meet black people.
Yes, we do.
So that's my question. So,
so let me put it out there. So if my husband and I catering company move next door to Cajun for the business.
I know what y'all like. Y'all like the gumbo.
Yeah, the bell pepper
sandwich with cheese on it.
Right? Yeah, would y'all come through?
Wait, can I ask you something?
Go ahead.
You pleasant to make that stuff, I'm just saying?
Oh, yes, indeed. He can make a lot of stuff. I can make a lot of stuff. Together, we are beasts. So would y'all support if I, look, let's put it this way. Would y'all support if I move next door to Chinese Kitchen?
I'm going to answer another. I got another question for you. In New Orleans, East past Michoud Boulevard, people call that Little Vietnam.
They do.
They have a two-story shopping center out there, a little further out.
Mm-hmm.
All of the signs on the stores are in Vietnamese. Why is that? So I'm asking that question. Somebody want to answer that on Sunisa Mine?
504-865-3635. 504-865-3635. Call us, guys. We want to hear your thoughts.
You know why?
Let's hear it.
They don't need your money.
Ooh.
I don't know if that sign says they sell shoes.
You don't know nothing.
I don't know if that sign says they sell crawfish. I don't know if that sign says you come in and get a massage. I have no idea.
Wow.
But I do know this.
that
they don't need
our money.
Because you can't read the signs. How would you know? So they didn't
need. So they didn't build the whole community back there. And how long they been back there?
Oh, since the storm came back. Since they came back from the storm.
So they have their own
store. They have their whole shopping center. And they got a few signs in English back there, but most of them signs are in Vietnamese.
And they got grocery stores that are just for them. Wow.
What does that say? And I need y'all to support Circle Food Store. Why?
Yes, please.
What's the Circle name? Mr. Boudreaux?
Yes.
Please go support. Oh, I got to say this, Holly Grove people. Tomorrow, free school supplies in Holly Grove at Conrad Park from 3 to 6, Journey Burnett.
Okay.
So go back there.
Wow. But so this is, you analyze these things, you pay attention to these things, and you fight. And you got your third eye on all the time.
Because them people think they know. Because they're not looking to play to you. They want your money. They absolutely want your money, but they're not trying to do anything. Like,
and they don't like to give you.
Let's bring up one, United Negro College Fund. So they have their walk coming up like in October or something like that. So I'm asking you, are anybody going to them stores and say, hey, y'all live in a 63% black city?
Can y'all support this?
Support it, yeah. Come out there and give us $1,000 or something.
Ooh, have anybody ever done that? That is something to think about.
And I can never finish introducing myself. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I own WSBN radio station.
Yeah. It's
24-hour gospel and inspirational music. And I advertise, market, and support African-American businesses. So if you need to advertise for your business, no matter what your budget is, come see me.
Yeah, no matter what your budget is, come see me. He helps people. He helps people. He has a passion. He is passed on.
I will never be wealthy. I am proclaiming that. You say, well, why are you saying that? Because it's true.
Why you say you ain't gonna never be wealthy?
Because I do too much. Because people come and say, hey, room, this going on, that going on, whatever. So, oh, I gotta say this too. I'm gonna invite people to come. We trying to show people there's another side of us that people don't know. So next Sunday, which is the 26th, we're having a picnic at City Park that my grandfather helped get us to. Come on.
So Zulu picnic is next weekend.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all hear that?
10 to 5. Come
10
on,
to 5. Zulu's picnic is from 10 to 5 at City Park where his grandfather helped us black folks to integrate in the City Park. So so Reuben, those genes, those characteristics, those characters has been passed down to you.
And guess what, Trinese? I can't fight. It's just me.
And it's in your bones. Yeah. And
so if anybody said they saw this on this show, come here. I'm gonna do a free commercial for you. Just come here. See what I'm saying? That's all. If you say you saw me and Trinese talking today, call me on the phone 940-8964 and I will give you one free commercial. One, and then after that you gotta.
See what I'm saying?
I'm 5 million people worldwide. That's that's my audience. All right.
Wow. So guess what, Reuben?
Yes,
what you got going on? Tell us the events.
Lord.
He got some things that's going on. And let me tell you guys, I had a chance to go to the gospel brunch. Are you guys still doing it? Or
no, because football, the Saints.
Did
you ever see the movie Concussion?
No.
They got a line in there. Albert Brooks tell a line in there.
Wow.
The guy said, I'm going to go against the NFL and tell them these people being hurt. The man got a line in the movie. I love it. He said, the NFL took Sunday from the church. How you going to go up against that? That's the biggest corporation in America. The NFL took Sunday from the church.
Ooh.
Y'all love y'all Saints. I'm going to see them tonight, y'all. Cool Saints.
Ooh,
you know,
wow.
I support the Saints. I know people get on me about other stuff. But we talk about it.
Yeah.
But I support the Saints. But anyway, this is what we got going
Mega mix-up.
If you came to the last one, you know it was awesome. So we came back.
I missed the last one, but I am going to be in the house. I'm going.
350 people were there last night. Free food. You can't beat it. Wednesday
free.
Night. And come meet all these African-American businesses, all these female-owned businesses.
Yes.
It's on Wednesday night, the 26th of September, and it's going to be wonderful. Free food, free drinks, not liquor. Don't come there asking for no Jack and Coke.
No, it's not that kind of party.
But not the Jack and Coke, anyway. Probably 40 businesses and nonprofits and people be there. Come meet your people and find out what they do. And please patronize these people. But it doesn't cost anything to get in.
Yeah.
You have to go to eventbrite.com and then search for Zulu Mega Mixer 2 and go ahead and sign up. And you on your way to get in. That's it.
So that's what Mr. Reuben DeTiege is promoting.
Right.
This Mega Mixer.
Come support small business.
It is free. and you have to get online, because the reason I think that most people are starting to do this, a lot of businesses are starting to, when they do free events, they want you to register because they need to physically see the support that was there. Right. They need to see those numbers.
Right.
Okay, because you know, you can show up and then you don't know how many people actually came.
Right.
And you need to compare, okay, is this working or is it not working? Right. So that's why it's important that you go to Eventbrite, and it's called the Mega Mixer Networking Event, and it's on Wednesday, yeah, September 26th. And it's at the Roy Glapion Hall on
South. Right next door to the Zulu.
Right next door to the Zulu from 6 to 8 p.m. I'm going to be in the house.
6 to 9, really.
Oh, it's really 6 to 9. Okay, 6 to 9.
Come. Let me say this to you. Mm-hmm. A lot of people doing these pop-up shops. The people that do, you take your money and...
The pop-up shops, you're not agreeing with? It's not good?
Well, tell me, I've
never been to one.
Well, here's one of the pop-up shops. Somebody rent a space, mm-hmm, then they invite the people in, and they sell them a table, and that's it. That's not what I do. This is a mixer. So when you... be a part of this, and we do have opportunities, so I do have some tables left.
Okay.
So call me 504-940-8964.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to help you market your event. I'm going to put you in front of 350 plus people.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do a commercial for you, and you're going to do a live interview at the radio station.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to market the event on television and on radio.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not like a regular thing. And when you come here, I'm going to, maybe this is a discouragement, but this is a working event. This is not sit down and play on your phone and play Candy Crush. I'm telling
yes.
you, I got you coming here, and I'm putting you in front of the people, so you got to capture that audience while you can.
Yes.
So we're going to play a game called Business Blackout Bingo.
Yes.
That means you have to visit every table.
Every table.
So we're going to do that, and that's going to be nice. We've done them in the past.
Yeah.
We have not had a one that has not been successful, so you want to go with something successful. The Zulu brand is strong. Want to see you out there.
That's a blessing.
Meet some wonderful people.
That's a blessing. Tell us about this other event that you have.
Oh, I'll tell you about that.
You bought a flyer for that?
No,
oh,
I don't have a flyer.
That's okay.
He didn't do the flyer yet.
Yes, that's okay.
We are doing the biggest gospel concert we've had in this city in quite a long time.
It's wow.
Several groups. It's going to be Professor Craig Adams and his Gospel Soul Children. It's going to be Jessica Harvey and The Difference. It's going to be.
Oh, okay.
The wonderful, exciting Zulu ensemble and exciting national recording artist Gail Fly.
Okay.
And last but not least, we're going to have Herman Magic Charles Gospel Legend.
Wow. Okay.
So we're going to see you there. It's going to be at Algiers Auditorium October 28th from 3 to 6 on a Sunday. We have vendors in that too, if you're interested in a vendor opportunity. Mm-hmm. We expect to have 500 people in the building.
Wow.
Come on, see us.
Wow, that's amazing. And what does that do for you when you see, when your events?
I want to encourage people to say, I saw Trinise there and I tasted her husband and her food.
Mm-hmm.
And next time we have a party or next time we have something, I'm not going to go to Cajuns. I'm going to go to them.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to recycle it.
It's all about planting those seeds.
And recirculating that money in the community.
Yeah, yeah. You it's know, important.
They came back, they did a study on the fact that in different ethnic communities, people change the way they circulate money. So what am I saying? In the Jewish community,
mm-hmm,
the money circulates for 28 days. And what that means is I made a dollar today. It doesn't leave our community for 28 days.
Wow.
What do you think it is for Black people?
Ooh, I think a few seconds, huh?
Yeah, it's 8 hours.
8 hours is
the time you get paid, and then you go get your hair fixed, you go get your nails done, you go to the store corner and buy a pack of cigarettes from those people and some cigarette people and a bottle of Taka Vodka. The money is going out of me.
Oh my goodness.
It is.
You say 8 hours.
8 hours. There are other communities always days. Even in the Hispanic community, it's like 5 or 6 days.
Really?
In African American people. It's only 8 hours
that our money stay in our neighborhood.
Right, it goes back down.
Ooh.
And I can remember when I was growing up, I'm going to just tell you, people say, well, we grew up in the 60s. It must have a lot of stuff. I was sheltered. My parents kept me in the neighborhood. They had a Black man that owned a store in the corner.
Okay.
And everywhere we went, we patronized Black people because of my grandfather.
Yes.
So when I saw people of another color, I mean, I was like, hey, howdy, how you doing?
Yeah, yeah.
Because I didn't think it was no different.
Yes.
But until I went to high school right down the street, and I learned a different thing.
Wait, what high school you went to?
Delaware.
Wow, you learned something. What did you learn?
I learned that racism is alive. alive and well and hit me in the face like a brick. Ooh. I went in there with a...
How did you handle that, Reuben? Because
it was hard because I lived in Holly Grove.
So what years was that you went to high school?
In the 70s.
Yeah. And you experienced...
Oh, I mean, go to school and they telling jokes. Like, I mean, we're sitting in the classroom. I'm one of 30.
Oh, what?
Oh, yeah. And then they
one of 30.
And then they sit in the classroom, they tell a joke like, how many black people take a screw and a light bulb? And I'm the only one sitting in there. I don't know what to say. And then they come back and say, oh, it's two. One, two. Hold a light bulb and I don't want to drive a Cadillac around the circle. And then the teacher in the front say, all right, let's go. All right, stop laughing, guys. Let's get back to work. And then I go back to Holly Grove and say, oh man, I would have hit that guy.
Oh,
what would I do if I jump up and hit some guy?
Yes.
And I'm the villain.
Yeah, so, wow.
I can't fight the whole school.
Let me ask you this. I'm glad we're talking about this. Let me ask you this, Reuben. So are you going to De La Salle in those times where it still was racist, even in the 70s?
Right. We had a black drum major, believe it or not. And say hello to Don Vapp. He was the greatest guy in the world.
Oh, wow. Don Vapp was a drum major? What?
He sure had De La Salle. He sure was.
Oh, that's amazing. That's amazing.
You know Don?
I know his family. Oh, right. I went to school with his nephew.
I was a freshman there. He was a senior.
Wow, really?
Yes, ma'am. That's true.
So let me say this. So what type of effect did that have on you?
Ooh.
You was there for 4 years. You graduated from there.
No, I left. I had to leave because I.
Okay, that's what I was about to say. So how in the world were you able? So how long did you stay? Just a year?
Yeah, I only stayed a year.
Did you beg to leave? Did you?
No, I just went to.
What you told your dad? Well, I was ready to go.
I said this is gonna turn out bad. I said I think you need to do something before you. I get back to the corner and then something else might happen.
So what school you went to after that?
LC Fort Chase Indiana School.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I went to St. Aug. I had a situation there. I left from De La Salle.
Okay.
Grades wise, I was doing good and so whatever. Then I left there.
Bullshit. Mm-hmm. And you, it was fine.
Yeah. I mean, you would. Let me say this. Hindsight is 20/20. I have some of the greatest relationships I ever wanted to have in my life there, but I got there. And curriculum. Again, mm-hmm. I say this to everybody, and I'm going to mention this again. Schools are not for children. Schools are for contracts and jobs.
Yes.
Children are only there for the headcount.
Mm-hmm.
You say that again, so you know. So let me see. Trinese is here. Mm-hmm. Orion is here. Who's here? All right, that's all I need to know. Feed them and push a book in front of them. But this school is about administrators making money and somebody getting a contract.
Especially these charter schools now.
That's all it's about.
These charter schools is the worst. Wow. So it really was about the children.
Never. I needed to know how many children I have so I know how much food to buy, how many books to get, and how many I'm going to count against the system. That's it. I mean, that's it. And that's a sad state of affairs, and it needs to get back to that. I just saw this morning on the news, New York University School of Medicine is going to give everybody this year free tuition, not books. And
really?
Not books and not housing, but the tuition is free because they say somebody has got to start the conversation about the price of education in this world. So if we don't have anything else but education that is of value to people, why does education and medicine cost so much?
Oh my goodness.
Why?
Yes, and healthy food.
Right.
Why does that cost so much? Healthy food, education.
You can get a Coke for a dollar.
Yes, you
can. A bottle of water is $1.50.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I was just talking about this yesterday. Let me say this, guys. Sickness and poverty keeps the wealthy wealthy.
Right.
Sickness and poverty keeps the wealthy wealthy.
And the former people pay more to live than rich people.
Yes. So we got to really pay attention and really take care of ourselves because at the end of the day, nobody cares about the poor. Nobody cares about you struggling. The people in high places don't care because if they care, they will make the healthy food more available, more affordable. They will put it in our neighborhoods. But instead, what do they do? And let me say this. You know, can you picture Ursuline Avenue right now?
Yes.
One side of Ursuline is who people? Another color.
Right.
The other side is another color.
Right.
Why is that? And there's so many streets like that, like one side will be white,
you know,
and no corner stores,
Right.
No corner stores, no check cashing places, no liquor stores.
Advertisement for cigarettes.
Cigarettes are not in those Caucasian neighborhoods, but they could be on the same street. But as soon as you cross over, broad.
I don't see any of those crime cameras on St. Charles Avenue. I have not seen one. So they don't have crime, or they didn't want the red and blue lights blinking. What? Tell me what it is. I'm trying
to. You didn't see one.
Tell me. So they don't need them? You tell me that. They don't need them? I guess I don't know.
Guys, we're just trying to open your eyes so you can understand and pay attention.
We ain't got enough time for this.
I know. We ain't got enough time. Because we'll be in here in here all day. We'll be here the whole week talking about it.
I broke your gift.
What you bought? Oh, okay. Thank you. Oh, cool. Thank you. Thank you. But we, I'm going to say this.
That was a WSBN brace.
I want to shout out to Mark in the Half Shell with his restaurant.
Yes, ma'am.
Because he's right on Bayou Road.
And they create black black Main Street. That's what I used to say Black Wall Street. I didn't mean it. It's Black Main Street. So all of this business is on one side, and I think that's due, I'll say, to the McKenna family. They had some property there, and they made sure black people have affordable places and a nice clean place to do business. So there's Whiskey and Sticks now with Ken
Jones.
And, it's Kelda Summer.
Now their place on Bayou Road too?
Right next door to Mark.
And really?
The Community Book Center, and I'm going to store, I'm going to tell people, please
support that.
There are no black bookstores anywhere.
Oh my goodness.
And we got to keep reading. Everywhere I fly, when I go out of town, My people are listening with earbuds and they listen. Thank you for listening, Aretha. You know what you got to do. Mm-hmm. When I travel out of town, everybody is reading. Please do not let books turn into historical things that people say one day. You know, they used to have books.
Ooh, now that's gonna be really scary. I'm right there.
Please read.
That right there.
You don't read any more than a magazine with some interesting articles. Mm-mm. But there are books written by wonderful authors out here, like this lady and other people, that you need to read.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not just like, you know, whatever, I don't read. And, you know, they always say stuff like that. If you don't have money in your house, where you put it?
In the book.
Why is that a joke?
Why is that a joke? Yeah, and they're trying to, you remember when we used to get Times Picayune 5 days a week?
Right.
It's what, 2 or 3 days now?
Yeah, and you're reading online because you're gonna go and you're reading.
The newspapers is almost on its way out of being.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So right. So what is that saying?
Because the cost of printing.
Yes.
I can do it much easier online and quicker, and it will get to the masses. But by the time I print a piece of paper and it winds up in the garbage, am I adding to the ecology and devastation of our environment? I don't know. But
yeah, let me say this. Everywhere you go, when it's time for you to pay for your transaction, what does it say? Print or email your receipt.
Right.
In a little while, it's gonna say just email.
Yeah, right.
And let me tell you guys something. Y'all better, those of you who are not computer savvy, technology savvy, who don't have a checking account or whatever, you guys better get with it, because eventually everything is going to be done.
Trinity, you know, I used to do a conference. I did a business conference, and I got some money from Good Word Network and with the FDIC, which is a Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation.
Okay.
Because there's so many people unbanked. This is what happened. When they got left here for Katrina, they picked up their check before they left that Friday, and they left. When they got to Houston, where they brought it to somewhere, and they said, I need to
cash my check.
I don't know.
See?
Ooh. So I had a conference, and I was trying to get more employers to put the money on a debit card. Now, what does that actually do?
Mm-hmm.
My goal was this in the beginning, without telling anybody. Sometimes you have to think psychologically.
Mm-hmm.
I got my stuff on a debit card.
Mm-hmm.
I don't need to go to the Middle Eastern people now and cash my check at the store, because when I get there, this is what I'm going to do. Mm-hmm. I had a hard day at work. I'm figuring out psychologically what to do, and I'm mad about some things. Me and Trinise didn't get on that morning. Mm-hmm. So when I get cash my check, they're going to take 30% of my check. One.
Yes.
Two, give me that pack of cigarettes while you're
there. Yes.
And, give me that bottle of liquor.
Yes.
So Now, yes, you get your money on a debit card. Oh, you got to find an ATM. You don't have to go to a main store.
Exactly.
That was my goal.
Yes.
I don't know if I did no good, but hey, hopefully.
That's what I'm saying.
Some employers that be able to do that with contractors and, you know, whoever else, because they're unbanked. Now you're a banked person. So that gives you a possibility that maybe this time I'll put $30 in the bank and hold on to that, because I don't know if I'm having a bad time.
Let me tell you something, Reuben. That's what I'm saying. So we got to get out of just cashing a check stages, because that's going to be
my money last till 2 weeks from now.
You guys got to get with it. You got to get your checking accounts in order, or if you have credit union. Oh, you guys need, listen to me. Those days of just cashing your check at Walmart might stop.
Please.
Because guess what? They charging you $3. That might not last. So you got to.
Let me get the concept. You're going to charge me $3
mm-hmm.
to give me my money.
Exactly.
What did exactly. you actually have to do to get the money?
Exactly. Exactly.
Nothing.
And also these ATMs. Look, perfect example. Yesterday, I had to get some money out. And my husband said, well, let's just go to the gas station. I said, oh, no, boo-boo.
She said, oh, no, boo-boo.
We going to my bank, and they ain't going to charge me nothing. He said, well, they got a 996. I don't care if it's a dime for me to charge my, to get my money out. I'm not giving nobody none of my money.
Let me explain this. Okay. If you need something and you at the gas station, they know you impulse buy.
Yes.
If you can wait.
Yes.
You go somewhere and get it in bulk.
Yes.
You would do much better. Then
right.
go to the gas station, buy one bottle of water.
Yes.
Go to Costco and get 40 bottles of water for $2.99.
Yes.
You get one bottle of water at the gas station, it's $1.69.
$1.69.
But it was cold and I was right there.
That's why they plant these corner stores in these neighborhoods, because what? We are impulse buyers.
And let me say this again.
We are impulse buyers.
My favorite thing. I don't hate to be morbid.
One day, mm-hmm.
hopefully it's 100 years from now. I'm going to say this in a kind of way. But you're going to die.
Yeah.
Sure? You're positive?
Yes, indeed.
Don't come call me Reuben. We got to go find me. Trinese passed away.
Mm.
We knew this.
Mm-mm-mm.
So why are we doing a GoFundMe? Mm-mm. Nobody wanted to go buy life insurance.
Right, right.
Oh, well, we didn't have money at the time.
Right.
You got to have it now. Though.
Right, right.
Please exactly. stop doing it.
Right, exactly. Yeah, stop doing it. And listen, guys, get your stuff in order.
And let me say this to you. Going to the club is not adding to the quality of life. So me and Trinese in the club, don't show me this video.
Wait, hold on.
We in here. Look at me and Trinese. We balling out. Travel. Get a passport and go see other foreign lands.
You want to get me thrown off there?
Before you die, go see Mexico, Canada, the easy ones. And then branch out from there.
Oh,
now you bowling. Tell me I'm wrong. Tell me what. Show me the lie. Show me the lie.
He ain't lying.
I'm just telling you.
It's true. And listen, guys, listen. He's not saying there's nothing wrong with going to the club.
Oh, not at all. Please.
No.
Because I go to sleep at 8:30. Yeah. Now people want to know, well, Room, you be up 4 o'clock in the morning.
Wait a minute. Oh, you get up at 4. Oh, you go to bed at 8 and get up at 4.
Well, I be struggling to see the news.
Oh, my God.
I'm old.
So you go to bed at 8:30?
Sometimes 9 to 8:30, something like that.
Oh, nah, bro.
When I finish this,
my child won't even go to bed that early.
I got a dude. I be saying, hey, man, get that homework. Let's go.
Yeah, yeah. Look.
And be looking at me probably like, dude, I hate this dude.
You know?
I know, I used to say that. I hate her.
Yeah, right.
I just walk outside and hit my car.
Nope.
Shit, you think I didn't? I ain't mind. She gone, not gone. I thought that.
Yeah, well, you look.
Because I didn't say it, because you were the same. What you said?
Yeah, yeah. Well, let me say.
I say nothing.
Let me tell you a funny story. Let me tell you a quick funny story. And you know, my son is 13, and you know how them kids are, they're preteens. So he on a game, and you know, you can talk to people online, and you're on a PlayStation 4, you can talk to people and all this. So he said, you know, because when we get on him about chores or whatever, right, you know, we not his best friend at that time. Of course, you know, when you on your child about certain stuff and they don't do it right, of course, you're gonna get the backlash. So one night, my husband decided to look at his text messages on his phone. And he said, yeah, my daddy know he's an a-hole.
I would not be here. I would have been in my at Providence Cemetery
Reuben, he woke him up like 3 a.m. Wake up. So I'm an a-hole, huh? We talked about this yesterday. I said, little boy, left your evidence. You didn't even delete your text. You know what I'm saying? And then we talked about it. So what makes you say that? He said, well, you know, y'all be on. I said, boy, you got it made in the shade. Okay?
Go in the bedroom and close the door and start punching the hell out of it.
Man, I'm just telling you, raising these kids today with all this technology, you just got to stay on them, because they'll get complacent and they'll get lazy and then all those things, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But again, Reuben, it's all about opening up and awareness, and some people are not going to like you for being raw and real.
I got haters like you wouldn't believe.
Keep on covered.
I got somebody by my back.
Yeah. God is good. And you know, and then you got people that really appreciate your authenticity and saying the raw things, because some people, they don't have the courage to say some of the things that we say.
I mean, no ill will anybody. I didn't come down here to do that.
Not at all.
Any hate on anybody and feel like nobody should, whatever. I even that idiot y'all having, what you call him?
What you think about that Amorosa?
She can't come back. Nah, I ain't taking her back.
Look, let me tell you, I'm not a fan of her.
But
homegirl to learn from that Trump.
He said he gonna arrest her. What she did? Arrest her for what?
She know too good.
You can't arrest somebody for violating an NDA. That's not a criminal offense. That's a civil offense.
Yeah.
If anything, you gonna arrest her.
Met his match.
It's 1929 Germany.
He met his match. And guess what? And she's saying the same thing. She said he didn't met his match. You know, but hey, you've been with Trump 14 years.
The scary part about that is, you know, and I'm saying this on here, and hopefully nobody, you know, that is, if she can sneak in the recording device in it, his security got to be real lax.
Ooh.
He brought in a situation from John Kelly did, mm-hmm, and that's supposed to be the most secure place on the planet.
Ooh.
That's what they call it.
Yeah. You got a point there, Reuben.
And he taped her. She taped him.
She was able to do it numerous of times, not just one time.
Oh, and then they stupid. They want to get a girl $180,000 to shut up. What kind of money you think that is? That ain't no money.
That's what they're offering.
Let me see. Yeah, $15,000 a month. If y'all want to give me that, I'll certainly take it. But it is what it is.
You know what? They all due respect, let me say this too. I don't wish any harm will on anybody.
I try to keep the word heat out of my vocabulary. Yeah, I don't hate anybody.
Yeah, but it hit me yesterday, Reuben, and I ain't gonna lie to you. It hit me yesterday when I was looking at some of the interviews that she's doing, and it hit me like a ton of bricks. I said, Lord, protect this woman. I said, because seriously, and like I said, I'm not a fan of her, but I don't want anything to happen to her. I see, because she's going against some heavy hitters, and because I'm talking about heavy hitters that are behind Trump,
right?
Okay, not Trump himself. I'm talking about the people that put him there, that want him there,
right,
and have a reason to have him there. But she's
people are very frisky lately. They come and say stuff to you and won't call the police.
Yes,
they're gonna use the police as a weapon,
yes,
of mass destruction and kill you or something.
Yes,
and
yes,
they're crazy. I'm telling you, boy.
Yes. So what I'm saying,
I'm not an Omarosa fan,
but she needs, I don't know. She's going pretty hard, and she didn't put an explosive book out and she's revealing a whole lot. So I'm saying, guys, we you know. Yeah, I pray for her. I'm just being honest with you. Pray for her because you have protection. Because you don't know.
I remember not liking her when she was on The Apprentice.
How you doing? All right.
and I didn't like her then.
Mm-hmm.
So my point to you is, with all of that, mm-hmm. I remember her being deceitful.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Right. So, I mean, she says mm-hmm. certain things and does certain things, and I don't believe nothing she says. She brought Kwame Jackson in a conversation, and he said he had no comment, because he didn't know what, I don't want to be around that lady and talk to her about anything. I'm still kind of upset about the Michael Clark Duncan thing,
because he died.
He died, and she buried him, and his parents, and his mom, and his sister, they still don't know.
What you mean they don't know what?
They don't think they know he's buried.
Wait a minute, what?
Yeah, she did all covertly. I think she married him, and then he got sick, and then he got away from his parents, and they didn't hear from him for a while. So the next thing they know, they hear from her that he's deceased, and there was some stuff going on like that.
Are you serious?
Oh yeah, we're looking up.
Wow. Oh wow. Okay.
That's crazy.
Okay. Well.
Now she's married to somebody.
She's
else.
Married to somebody.
So does she have Michael Clark Duncan's money? Or who knows?
Ooh.
Crazy.
It's crazy. Well, again.
Hi, everybody. How y'all doing?
Well, let me say this. Before we get off the air, I want to share some news with you guys. Of course, guys, you guys know that I have two shows that's coming up. I decided to do Sweet Willie's Cotton Club.
Oh, sorry, congratulations.
Thank you. I decided to do it again, but in a different way. Because we're going to do late night, meaning it's more of an adult theme, meaning we're going to have poetry, we're going to have raw comedy, uncut.
Burlesque?
Huh?
Burlesque?
Well, no, I wouldn't say burlesque.
Oh,
not
I was
any,
coming.
Oh!
I'm just
no, kidding. We ain't doing no burlesque, but we're gonna definitely have some sexy, classy stuff going on.
Okay.
But we're gonna keep it, you know, it's gonna be the theme back in the day, you know, everybody's gonna be, you know, Sweet Willie's Cotton Club. So we're gonna have, of course, DDD, my character, is gonna do some raw comedy. We have, you know, get some other comedians to come up, and we're gonna have some poetry, and it is gonna be fantastic. So those of you who, you know, you get off on Friday, and you need something to relax and inhale, and you want to bring your boo, your man, your lover, or whatever it is, your husband, your wife.
Side piece.
You said it, not me. And bring them to enjoy an atmosphere of good singing, jazz and blues singers. Some people are going to be singing at Etta James, that Billie Holiday, that Sam Cooke, some Donny Hathaway. We introducing some Donny Hathaway.
That's great.
So we're going to have all that in one night, only for $20. $20, you can't, in live band. Alive, and so we're doing it, Sweet Willie's Cotton Club, the late night edition, meaning that you can give, you have tone to get hot. The show going to start at 10 o'clock. We're probably going to start at 10:30, give you time to get there. That's on October 19th at 10 o'clock at Cafe Istanbul, one of my favorite places to perform. Shout out to Chuck Perkins for let me tell you something. I've been hanging with Chuck since 2012. That's really where I built my career at Cafe Istanbul. Yes. Yeah, him and Suleiman. But
let me say this, Trinity.
Sure.
Yeah, I want to say I think you do a wonderful service to the city, and you are a treasure. And you, the fact that you bring these entertainment venues to people that they don't have, and it's something out of the norm, I think you should be applauded. And I think
thank
that's
you.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
You don't agree. I mean, you can see the work and the dedication and the time that you put into these performances. So I wanted to say this.
Yeah.
Bottom line,
right.
Thank you for the city of New Orleans that you put this out.
Thank you, Reuben. It is definitely passion and love for it. See, when you got those ingredients,
boy, absolutely.
You're gonna put it in, and you want to see others shine too. So I just know that I'm here to, this is what God created with me, these gifts
right.
to write and to envision,
you
to be a visionary.
You are here for a reason.
I'm here for a reason, and I'm an old soul too. I'm an old soul school. I've always
say hello to your mom.
Oh yeah, hey mom. I don't think she's on. She's probably teaching. But hey mom, Terry Jordan, and that's a funny thing how you know her too. It's
you know what? We worked together right here.
Right here.
I had a class here with her.
Yes.
She taught that class. I can't even remember what it was, but it was fun.
Yeah. She said, "Oh yeah, I know Reuben." I said, "Oh, just small world." So, to all that to say, I appreciate your compliment, and guys, it's all about the love, and we got jewels in this city. We got treasures in this city. And so many treasures have left. So that's why it's important to support those treasures that you have.
Right.
and such as yourself, Reuben. Support, just support quality. I want to say this, quality.
I want you to do me a favor.
Sure.
When my time comes and I go, one, I don't need no second line because I didn't play music. Two, don't put me on no t-shirt. Okay.
Ooh. Y'all heard it from his own mouth.
I don't Ooh. Want no second line because I didn't do anything musically. So I think that's for people that do music.
Really? Okay. That's how you feel. That's what just your wishes.
And then two, I don't want to look down. Hopefully I'll be up and look down and say, oh, they put me on a shirt.
Oh.
And I want a pair of socks. Have some dignity. Put on a jacket and come see me. Don't come there with your pants hanging off. I wouldn't do that to you.
Oh, so okay. So Reuben putting it out there. He don't want no t-shirt face on no t-shirt. And he don't want a second line.
I don't want nobody backing it up coming out Martin Luther King. I don't need it. I didn't back it up in real life. So
Let me say,
if you want that, I'm gonna come do that for you.
Look. It's so funny that you said that because my husband
Aretha Franklin got a second line. Wait a minute.
Oh, don't get me started.
Prince got a second line. What? Some people they recorded that. Oh, the people in New Orleans, go ahead and back it up for a minute. You know, did they have a second line for Michael Jackson?
Yes. Look. I hate anything the second line for, but I'm going to say this.
My chicken died.
Let me say this, guys. I we got cultures here, different cultures. I don't second line either. I just don't. But
you make people start shooting. I don't know why.
I don't know
like,
stuff
like Waffle House. Something about pancakes and syrup at 4 o'clock in the morning make you want to fight people.
What?
I'm going. We're coming in from out of town. Hey, you want to stop me something? No.
Ooh, we ain't going to no Waffle House. Because you get killed over there. Oh man, God. It's crazy.
Some angry
shot.
Females in there throwing. Oh, Trinisa. Oh, my God. What y'all ate? The syrup? It was the milk? What, it was coffee? Oh, my God.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
They're yelling black. Keep moving. Keep
him
moving.
Man,
I don't want nothing.
Man, that's funny you saying it because one time my husband said, "Okay, man, let's go to Waffle House. It's 12 midnight." I said, "I just want to go to Waffle House." He said, "Girl, come on here, let's go to Waffle House." I'm sitting there like
old man tip right here. Look at me. I'm gonna look in the camera. You want something to eat late tonight? Go to Anita's. They feed you so much.
Oh yes,
you
yes.
You can't fight. All you want to do is go to sleep.
Yeah.
Nobody even tapping you on the shoulder when they get on. Hey, yup, no, I'm about to go to sleep. I had that pancake. It was that thick. Go to Anita's. I ain't even getting no money for this commercial. There's no fighting in Anita's.
But wait a minute, they ain't 24 hours no more. I don't think they're 24 hours. I think everybody will be in Anita's.
And crack an egg like you used to do. And fry egg at home.
Ruben said, "Don't you go to no Waffle House." Mm. He said, "He don't want to see you on no front page."
They have more fights than they have on Showtime. Showtime boxing. You know, they have Waffle House boxing.
Oh man, you well.
Chairs go to flying. Oh my God.
look.
They got a channel, Waffle House video.
No. Mm-mm. I ain't gonna. I know you lying.
They must put something in the food. I'm telling you. They can't be that many confrontational people on the planet.
Man, look. Let me tell you something.
I'm getting all off of social.
No. That's okay. But like I was saying, let me get back to what I was saying. Absolutely. So anyway, guys. Sweet Willis Cotton Club. Oh, and yeah, we got to talk about this too. Yeah, okay. Sweet Willis Cotton Club. October 19th. The show starts at 10. Get there. It's going down. $20. We're on stageplay.ticketleague.com. You can get your tickets online, or you can pay at the door. It's a couple of more dollars at the door. And then we're going to the gospel play, God Sees on My Wedding Pen. Your wife was able to come to that. Tell me, what did she say about it? Give me that review.
Now they first said that when they was going, I'm put you on blast. They first said, we don't want to eat. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then they seen the poor people eating.
Mm-hmm.
We should have got the food. Because they was eating the food. And it looked so good. I was going to eat meat.
You said you was getting the tickets for them to get the food. They said they ain't want the food.
Don't worry about it. We Okay, all right, okay. Save me a couple of dollars. I don't care. And look, kept going back and forth with it. Trinise, I need to take 30 days. It's too late. Okay.
Yeah, you called me that. You called me the day of.
Yeah,
and only a few people I answer the phone for on the day of my production.
And then they call me like, well, I think we changed our mind. It's too late. Wait, they try to get you to use your influence. Ain't that your friend? I'm not. That lady got put on a production, and she got to make sure that I'm not putting no pressure on nobody for that. Y'all, make up your mind.
Ruben, you lucky I answered the phone.
Right.
Because you my friend. I said, let me answer the phone because they had other people calling me. I answer the phone.
Look, and I'm in a bag, and they're going, girl, you should have went to the thing. It was good. It was this and that. And you know, Aranisha was in it. Oh, my God.
Well, it was a 2 sold out show, a successful show. The food was fantastic. And we're doing it. We're going to Baton Rouge, guys. We're going to be there December the 8th at the Mount Pilgrims Outreach Center in Baton Rouge.
That's our Shelly
Garrison. Mm. My desire has been to get on the road and bring these places to other cities, and we're going to do that. So, guys, you know, those of you who want to follow me on Facebook, who are listening online, who are listening and can't watch me live, but you can follow me on Facebook, Trinise J. DePlessis, or follow the God's Tears on My Window Pane page, and you can get all the updates of what we're doing. And you know, it's a lot happening. So back to Reuben DeTiege event that's coming up really pretty soon.
What is it?
The Mega Mixer.
September 26th.
September the 26th.
And it's free if you just want to attend. If you want to event, give me a call, and I'll tell you about all that, but it's great.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to be at the Zoom. Roy E. Glapion Hall. So there. And it's going to be very, very nice. It's going to be music. We're going to live stream it. We've got a couple of radio stations there. You can talk to some people, meet them. And the people are going to be giving out stuff at their table. So it's like walking through Essence, but not with Essence.
Exactly.
Remember Essence used to give you all that stuff?
Yes.
You're going to come and get a lot of stuff.
Yes.
I gave Denise one what I'm giving away. I gave this bracelet.
Yes. So I would be, the bracelet. Yes. Yeah, so Mr. Reuben DeTiege, we appreciate you coming in.
I appreciate you. And a gospel concert coming up in October, so start looking for stuff on Facebook for that.
Yes. And tell me how they can follow you, my audience. Tell people how they can follow you. But I know you maxed out, but they still can follow you on your page. So tell people, you have a small note. If you got to
knock off somebody.
Huh?
If you tell me you're with Trinise, I'll knock off somebody and put you on. But I got 2 pages, Reuben DeTiege, R-E-U-B-E-N-D-E-T-I-E-G-E. I have a WSBN Digital Media Group. I have Small Business in the World, and anybody can post anything. If you got a business on there, you can put it on there. We have 2 other little pages, one called Small Business in the World, the Business Directory. You can go on there. Mm-hmm. And then I have some called Entrepreneurs Institute, where I teach what I know to try to help you be successful. Again, all of that is free. I got to start making money, Trinise, because I'm going to be on the street homeless.
No, don't say that. Don't say that.
And let me see that. Everybody been seeing a homeless lady on the internet.
Oh, please say something about that. I want to say something, too.
That lady is very ill. And
very ill.
You know, I know that's attractive, and guys like to tell jokes.
Yes. Yeah, I wasn't feeling that.
I don't think anybody ought to try to approach that lady, because I understand she don't even know her daughter anymore. So I don't know what happened there, but it was something tragic. You see somebody outside, they are out there for a reason. It's not like they just came out there.
Yes.
They said, let me live under a bridge.
Yeah.
They are out there for a reason.
Yeah.
And I just am ashamed that Bobby Jindal destroyed the mental health system in the state of Louisiana like it is.
He was terrible for our he was terrible for our state.
And you know, people say, that's criminal. We ought to do something. No, they can't, because it's just incompetence. He wasn't prepared to be governor.
No, he wasn't.
He had the poor leadership, and for some reason, I'm going to put this out there, and it's probably an ugly thing to say, but Bobby Jindal thinks he's a white man, and he's going to treat up their values, and he's not.
Yes.
He lost whatever values I'm sure he learned.
As
an Indian and as a Buddhist.
Yes.
So now he's Christian and whatever, and he changed his name, white culture got to him, he changed his name to Bobby, from Bobby Brady. What?
Exactly.
His name ain't Bobby.
Yes. So it's real talk, guys.
But thank you for letting me come on.
No problem, guys.
I had fun on here.
I had fun too.
We gotta stay woke, people.
Stay woke. So, guys, we're gonna close it out. Again, I'll be here next Friday with Dr. Ray.
Oh my goodness, I gotta watch that show.
She will be in the house, Dr. Ray. Dr. Ray gonna be in the house.
Dr. Ray Pert.
Dr. Ray Pert, yes. And she's amazing. She supported my play. I was glad to see her there with her husband. So she'll be on the show next Friday. And that's the 24th of October, guys. Make sure you tune in. And then I will be downloading this video and uploading it on video on YouTube. So those of you who just joining, you can go back and watch the whole thing. Again, thank you, Reuben, for coming in. We'll see you guys next time. Have a fantastic weekend. Do something special.
Hey, come and to the giveaway.
The giveaway.
Back to school giveaway in Holly Grove, 0017.
Okay.
Back in the Conrad Playground.
Okay.
3 to 6. Entertainment, awesome. Food, everything. Free. Awesome. Everything free. Everything.
Awesome. And y'all keep on playing them Aretha Franklin songs and enjoying yourself. Stop. All right, y'all. Peace out. Thank y'all for support. Shout out to everybody. I'm going to just call y'all by name right quick. I like the Ronald, Cousin Ronald, Davenport, Audrey, Sandra, Big Moses, Roxine, Sybil, Tamika, Big Moses, Tara, Rhonda, Obama, LaToya. Who else is on here? Damien, Lamont, Christy, Dizzy, Tanisha, Joe, Diane, Altima, Cortea, Weldon, Randolph, Tracy, Demond, Kiwana, James, Omar, Nikki, Brian, who else is on here? Nan, Natasha, Michael, all you guys, Chantelin, thank you guys for watching and supporting the show. We'll be back next Friday, and I will see you soon. Peace and blessings.